The St. Regis Parish family gathers to celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. There are two announcements. The festival committee has posted signs with a QR code leading to All Things Festival, or please go to Gillen Hall and sign up for a 2-hour time on the volunteer sheets. All volunteers will receive a ticket for a free sandwich, as well as a chance to win prizes. Continue bringing in your finished baskets for the basket raffle. Instructions are in the bulletin. Also, gather your favorite recipes. We will need baked goods for our festival bake sale. The festival is 3 weeks away, July 21st and 22nd. A reminder, all ministers and volunteers need clearances. Once you get your clearances, they will last 5 years. On Sunday, July 9th, after Mass, we are offering a clearance fair where you can get your clearances easily and quickly. Call the parish office if you have any questions about clearances and the clearance fair. That's Sunday, July 9th, after Mass, clearance fair for all volunteers and ministers.
Please pick up the hymnal and turn to the opening hymn, number 617, Baptized in Water, number 617.
Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, cleansed by the blood of Christ our King, heirs of salvation, trusting his promise, faithfully now God's praise we sing. Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, dead in the tomb with Christ our King, one with his rising, freed and forgiven, thankfully now God's praise we sing. Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, marked with the sign of Christ our King, born of one Father, we are his children, joyfully now God's praise we sing.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, we share a common baptism, and we share a common call by virtue of that baptism into the presence of the Lord to be strengthened in word and sacrament, that we may grow in that life in Christ, which we begin in baptism. As we gather and begin this celebration of the Eucharist, let us call to mind our sins, those times that we have failed to live faithfully that life in Christ. And let us ask our merciful God for pardon and peace. You give us new life in baptism. Lord, have mercy. You have destroyed the power of death. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Your light shines through your disciples. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elijah came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elijah is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elijah arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elijah asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant, Gehazi, answered, "Yes, she has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elijah said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elijah promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. The promises of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations, my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, "My kindness is established forever." In heaven, you have confirmed your faithfulness. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. Blessed the people who know the joyful shout. In the light of your countenance, O Lord,
day. And through your justice, they are exalted. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. You are the splendor of their strength, and by your favor your horn is exalted. For to the Lord belongs our shield, and the Holy One of Israel our
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. Announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. Whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My seminary professor, who taught us about the writings of St. Paul, said you could summarize Paul's teaching on faith and baptism very simply, that we're saved by faith, we're saved by our baptism, and so if we are saved people, then we have to act like it. And so that is our challenge, our call as disciples. The gift is freely given. Today's second reading is a continuation of what we heard last week as Paul is building his theology of baptism. The word baptize, the original Greek baptizo, means to immerse. In baptism, we are immersed. That's why many fonts, like our baptismal font here, is made in such a way, because in the ancient church, when you were baptized, you didn't just have water dumped on your head. You were immersed, literally, dunked into the waters of baptism, immersed into the baptism, symbolizing that by birth, by virtue of our baptism, we are immersed into the death and resurrection of Christ. And that's Paul's point in the reading that we hear tonight. When we are baptized, we die with Christ in the waters of baptism, that we may rise with him to the fullness of life. We are immersed in the death and resurrection of Christ. And that is a gift that is freely given to us. We do not earn baptism. There is nothing that we can do to deserve baptism. But it is a freely given gift. The life that we have in Christ Jesus is a life that is freely given to us. And as we are immersed in baptism, as we are immersed into the death and resurrection of Christ, we then have the responsibility to live that life. Because as we are immersed in baptism, as we are immersed into the life of Christ, we are then being called to follow after Christ. Jesus, by virtue of his own death and resurrection, has put death and sin to death. He has conquered it once and for all by the sacrifice of the cross. And we who share in that life are being called by Christ to grow in what we have received. That is what a life of faith is. We are constantly growing into what we are called to be. We are constantly being called by Christ every day of our lives. We are called to move beyond sin. We are called from death into life. And as we listen to the teachings of the gospel, as we adhere to the teachings of the gospel, as we conform our hearts and minds to Jesus Christ, we are answering the call. We are little by little, day by day, bit by bit, growing into the fullness of life to which we are called. Just as Christ has conquered sin and death once for all, we who share in his life, we who are alive for God in Christ Jesus, are being called beyond the limitations of life. We are being called into the fullness of life. And when we put the teachings of Christ into practice, it's then that we're answering the call. Our gospel today is a continuation of what we've heard the last few Sundays. It's Jesus commissioning his apostles to go out into the world. You remember a couple weeks ago, he called them by name. He continued the commissioning last week, and we hear kind of the conclusion of it in the gospel that we hear today. We can't let anything get in the way. Jesus uses very strong language here. You can't love mother or father more than me. Whoever loves brother or sister more than me is not worthy of me. Whoever is not willing to carry his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Jesus is intentionally using very strong language here because that call to discipleship, that call to go out into the world and to announce the good news is urgent. And we can't let anything get in the way. And that's the point that Jesus is making. We who share in his light, we who have been set free from sin and death by virtue of our baptism, by virtue of our life in Christ, to answer the call to discipleship, to proclaim the good news in thought, word, and deed in our lives, is an appropriate response to the gift that we have received from God. To share hospitality. You know, we may lose sight of this, but in the ancient cultures of biblical times, like we hear today in the first reading, to offer hospitality in a harsh and dangerous place was really of God. The woman of Shunem recognizes that Elisha is a great prophet, this holy man of God. And so her and her husband offer hospitality. They give of themselves for the prophet. And they are rewarded as they do as they are supposed to do. When we answer the call to discipleship, when we practice charity, which is at the heart of the gospel, when we put into practice that great theological virtue that outlasts everything else, we are growing in that life that we already have in Christ Jesus. We are answering that call to discipleship. When we conform our hearts accordingly, we are growing in the life that we have already received. And we need the grace that we get here. The grace as we listen to God's word. The grace as we share in the body and blood of Christ. The grace as we come into the Lord's presence here as his body to offer praise and worship, to be strengthened by the prayers and the community of one another. In so many ways, we are being graced. And as we receive that grace, we answer the call. As we come here, as we sang in our opening hymn today, we are baptized in water. We are immersed, submerged in the life, the death, and resurrection of Christ, his life in us. And he calls us to grow in that life. He is calling us from sinfulness, calling us from death into life. That's the call that we receive here. That's what we are strengthened to do as we come here, to listen to that call and then to respond by a life of discipleship. We are indeed alive for God in Christ Jesus. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him
all things were made. For us men,
for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. To the God whose kingdom claims our heart's first loyalty and love, let us pray through Jesus, in whose mission and ministry we share.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church throughout the world, by the witness and devotion of her people and ministers, may she always be a source of welcome to all who wish to come into her arms. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of nations, may they work for greater acceptance of each other's cultures and a spirit of cooperation between nations seeking to resolve world conflicts, especially in Ukraine. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick or are nearing the end of their days on earth, may they find the peace of Christ in their hearts and in the comfort given by their families and friends. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the United States of America, that our government and freedoms will be preserved and we will pursue justice and liberty for all. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, may they come to enjoy perfect happiness and peace in the heavenly kingdom. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
During this Mass, we remember in a particular way the living and deceased members of the St. Regis Parish family. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold deep in our hearts, which we now pause to add.
Pour forth into our hearts, strong and faithful God, the wisdom and daring of your Spirit, that we may take up our cross and follow Christ, willing to lose our lives for his sake, and to manifest to the world the hope of your kingdom. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God has chosen me, God has chosen me to bring good news to the poor. God has chosen me, God has chosen me to bring new sight to those searching for light. God has chosen me, and to tell the world that God's kingdom is near, to remove oppression and break down fear. Yes, God's time is near, God's time is near, God's time is near, God's time is near.
has chosen me, God has chosen me to set a light on new fire. God has chosen me, God has chosen me to bring to birth a new kingdom on earth. God has chosen me, and to tell the world that God's kingdom is near, to remove oppression and break down fear. Yes, God's time is near, God's time is near, God's time is near, God's time is near.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with all the angels and saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Larry, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Junipero Serra, Saint Regis, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Jesus has taught us to call God our Father, so we have the courage to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Christ's peace. Christ's peace. Christ's peace. Christ's peace. Christ's peace.
On us, Lamb
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The communion hymn is number 661, One Bread, One Body. Number 661.
Blessing which we bless. this one, Lord.
Call our Eucharistic minister, the homebound, to come forward. God provides for all his children, and so we send you to the afflicted among our brothers and sisters, that you may share with them the word and the body of Christ, and share with them our joy. Go in peace. Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We had another one of those unpleasant surprises happen last week. I came in on Monday morning, came over for Mass, and found water dripping from the ceiling in the sacristy. And around the entry door over there. We had a pipe right above the sacristy is where the teacher's lounge used to be when the school was here, and there is a sink in there, and one of the pipes broke in the sink, and water was everywhere. So when Joe, our maintenance man, came in Monday morning, he got the water turned off. We got the plumbing problem fixed by early afternoon on Monday, but we had a lot of water up there that needed to be taken out, and there is still water. It's actually still damp. So the diocese had a disaster restoration company come in on Tuesday. If you were here any time during the week, you heard the gentle hum of giant dehumidifiers and fans running in the sacristy and in the entryway to the church over there. Much of the walls and everything are dry. We still do have some wet areas, so everything was taken down so that there's not an obstacle course for you to run to get out of church. But they'll be coming back tomorrow to complete the process. Hopefully by about Tuesday or Wednesday, everything will be dry and all the equipment will be taken out, and then we'll be able to assess how much replastering has to be done, what has to be repainted, and so forth. It's one of those times you should say, thank God you have insurance. That's one of the benefits of being part of the diocese. We are covered by insurance for all of our buildings, so we'll have to pay our deductible, but everything except for the plumbing, but all the other work should be covered by insurance, but things will be have been a little out of sorts this week, and they'll be yet for a few more days, and then we'll get everything back in shape. So hopefully that's the last of our unpleasant surprises, and we get better ones ahead. Festival is 3 weeks away, as you heard, so please get those baskets in. If you took a tag from the donation tree, get the donations in. We still have a few more tags left on the tree, and the festival's coming in 3 weeks. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
The closing hymn is number 900, Go, Make of All Disciples. Number 900.
Go make of all disciples, we hear the call of Lord that comes from you, our Father, in your eternal word. Inspire our ways of learning through earnest, fervent prayer, and let our daily living reveal you everywhere.
Go make of all disciples, baptizing in the name of Father, Son, and Spirit, from age to age the same. We call each new disciple to follow you, O Lord, redeeming soul and body by water and the word. Go make of all disciples, we at your feet would say, until each life's vocation shows forth your holy way.
We cultivate
the nature God plants in every heart, revealing when our witness the master teachers are.